Hey, this is Mike Lindsay from Vital MX. We're out here at Milestone today and we're testing out the 2018 Husqvarna FC450 Rockstar Edition. So of course, this is the first year that Husqvarna's had their own special edition motorcycle. We're calling this one the Rockstar Edition. It's all logoed up like the race team bikes. They're gonna show up at A1. And for you guys that want in the public, you can go out and get one a little bit earlier if you're willing to buck up a few extra dollars. Now, why would you do that? That's because the bike actually has quite a few changes this year. The biggest change this year is the frame. We're talking about the spar thicknesses, the angles, all the things that come together to really create how the bike flexes and how it feels out on the track. Now, we've all commented before in the previous Husqvarna, just the KTM or the Husqvarna period, is how good the chassis are overall. But what they're really focusing on is still just giving the bikes a little bit more of a precise feel. And by doing that, they're going for torsional rigidity by increasing that. And that's basically your twisting side to side kind of motion, the bike in the center pivot. The idea is there is they're just trying to get the bike so it doesn't feel like it flexes so much those instants. So when you go into the corner, as you come into the entrance, it makes the bike feel more precise, like it has more feel as you roll in. And then it also improves the rear end traction. The previous Husky 450 felt like it flexed a lot in the rear, which was really good in hard pack situations, but if the traction was really good, you could feel the bike kind of twist a little bit under heavy loads. The new one we rode today has a much more precise feel. You're able to kind of rear steer the bike a little bit more, and you have more of a precise feel from the rear. It doesn't feel like it starts to build energy and then snap loose. Because one thing the Husqvarna and, of course, KTM have been really well touted on the past years is that comfort from when front to rear motion, when you're hitting chop, when you're hitting braking bumps, landing, the amount of flex that the bike has kind of that front to rear motion has been really good. And that's where we found a lot of extra comfort out of that chrome alloy chassis that some of the Japanese brands don't have. My opinion after riding it today, I think overall the bike has gone stiffer in every aspect a little bit. I do notice a little bit more feedback in the front end on bumps than I did on the previous bike, but it's not a bad way. It's not a chatter, it's not a harshness. I just feel a little more energy in my shoulders off the hits, a couple little things, but once again, it's not bad. The bike has really increased feel all over. For me, the two biggest improvements was that rear tracking I mentioned, and then the second is really how the bike carves into the rut. It's not just the entrance, but it's the middle feel. The track we rode today at Milestone had a couple ruts that some guys had kind of messed up in the morning. They had a lot of hooks, a lot of abruptness in the middle corner, a lot of places where, especially on a 450 with a lot of power, I would struggle getting through those hooks without standing up the bike and just grabbing a handful of throttle and kind of popping up and following the line that's already been made. I was actually really impressed today with the Husky, with the new chassis, how well I was able to feed the front tire through that hook and able to continue a better motion through the corner due to the feedback I was able to get. So engine-wise, the bottom end up is really all the same. They do have a new transmission. It's just a different supplier company that KTM owns, Pankel. Other than that, the ratios are all the same, rod, crank, all those goodies. With the head, they've been able to compress it down 15 millimeters. They basically have taken the design, the cam, the valves, everything, and they've been able to shrink it down. We've lost a pound of actual engine weight because of that, but mostly the goal is to just try to bring that mass down in the bike. They've also lowered the radiators for the same reason. They're just trying to bring that weight down the motorcycle to make it feel even lighter than it really is. The actual intake port angle is exactly the same. They've been able to change the exhaust port a little bit though. The head pipe's different. The intake lobe on the cam is a slight bit different, and the mapping. The reason being is they're trying to get the bike to be a little bit more lively. We've commented before that the Husky's revs slower than the KTM's because of the airbox. Even though they have a new airbox this year, they really didn't improve the flow in any aspect. They tried to get the bike to kind of snap to life and come on quicker through all these other changes. Now saying this, the actual response of the bike from the crack of the throttle really doesn't feel any different. The Husky is still extremely smooth. It really doesn't have any extra bark over the previous engine, but it does come on quicker. When you get into that throttle, the previous bike just felt like it took longer to get through the rev range. The new bike gets through the rev range quicker, gets up into the mid, into the top where it makes a lot of power and just gets you to that next gear a little bit quicker. As for the suspension, the components we're actually working with are the same as the previous year. The shock body's completely the same. The AR48 fork's the same, the tapers, the length, all that. It's just setting changes, which is actually really good news for anybody that has kit suspension. We figured out all the track shocks, all the other stuff from the previous bike will fit on the new one. But like I said, for this year, they've tweaked the settings slightly to kind of adapt to the new chassis. just once again to just get the best range of control they can out of it. For me, I'm a little bit on the light side. We couldn't get 105 millimeters of sag. We're at like 102. So I slowed down the rebound a little bit, took a little high speed compression out of it, just tried to get it to settle a little more for me. Overall, the action was really great. I have no real complaint in that department. The only thing is softening it up and deadening it up like I did. Did cause it to pack a little bit in repeated hits, but if we were to swap out the spring rate for something that would adapt closer to my weight, I'd be able to speed up the rebound just a couple clicks and get rid of that kind of packing feel I had at a few points. The AER 48 air fork on this bike, I felt like was a little bit more progressive than the previous generation. I don't want to say I was lacking comfort, but I didn't feel like I was maximizing the use of the stroke initially, so I went a few more clicks softer than I did on that previous version just to make sure I took advantage of the entire stroke. I was able to get a little extra comfort out of it just to kind of add to the extra rigidity we have in other areas. I felt like I was able to really balance out my total feel in the bike. The bodywork being all new isn't just for show either. It's really an ergos thing with these guys. They're trying to get, you know, the current generation Husky, the one that we're just coming out of, is quite skinny in the center rider compartment. When you're standing, it feels real thin between the legs. But as you get far forward or back on the bike, some guys comment that it feels a little wide in some areas. Basically, with the new bodywork, they're trying to trim down that transition, keep it thinner, longer each way. At the peak of the radiator shrouds, it's still the same width as the outgoing bike, but the taper getting there is a lot different. That's partially from bringing the radiators down 12 millimeters. They've been able to roll the top of the shrouds over it a little more just to make that taper pretty much wait to get to its widest point later. So when you're going forward on the bike, it stays skinny for a much longer period of time. Same thing coming off the back, the way they've positioned the exhaust, the way they've done the airbox, they've just tried to make it so those side plates don't get wide till the last possible second. For me, I ride more middle to front of the bike, so I really can't comment on the improvement in the rear. From the center of the foot pegs up till around the front of the fuel tank, I definitely noticed a good improvement. It made me more confident getting out over the front of the bike, getting my way forward, my knees forward, mostly because I almost didn't realize I was that forward on the bike because it stayed skinny that long before it tapered out. The last ergo change was with the handlebars. They went to a new pro taper bend that's really low. Because of that, the actual width of the bar is a little bit wider. For me, real comfortable. I'm a smaller guy. It gives it a very racy feel, down low, kind of on the bike in the corners. But I will admit, for somebody that's probably closer to the 6 foot range or above that stands up real straight, they're gonna notice it's a little bit too low for them. I will say, when I saw the initial photos of this bike, with the launch specs and everything, I was a little bit disappointed. I thought for a bike of this nature that it wasn't the drastic overhaul that I expected them to have before the Supercross season, that they felt like they needed the bike this early. But after getting to see the bike in person, definitely looks a lot better when you actually get to see it. And then talking to the engineers about the changes and then finally getting to swing a leg over today, you know, they've done a lot of work with the engines the past couple years. 450s are fantastic. They just threw everything they could at how this bike handles. And after riding today, those changes are worth it in my mind. And I would definitely pick this over the previous generation bike pretty easily.